Let's talk about text editing. If you have a topic selected, just start typing to replace the text. If a topic is selected, it'll have a blue border, and if you're editing the text, it has a red border. If you want to insert text partway along a topic, you can click a selected topic and you'll be put into editing mode with the cursor at the point that you clicked. If you want to edit just using the keyboard and want to edit the existing text without replacing it in its entirety, select the topic and press Shift Command Quote, and then use the arrow keys to position the cursor where you want to edit and edit from there. You can also double-click to select a word or triple-click to select a whole paragraph. These actions can be done whether the topic was already selected or not. When you've finished editing the topic, just press Return to finish editing. If you're editing and want to insert a new line within the same paragraph, press Ctrl Return. And if you want to insert a new paragraph, press Shift Return. If you don't have a particular paragraph spacing set, a new line and paragraph break may look the same, but they will behave differently when you apply paragraph-related settings, for example changing the text alignment. The text formatting options are available on the Text Inspector. All of the options on the Text Inspector operate on either the selected text if you're editing the text at the time, or the selected topics if you're not editing the text, and also will operate on the notes text if you're editing the notes. The first button opens the font panel. From there you can select the font that you want to use. We recommend that you use the font set fonts from the bottom of the font panel so that if you want to change the formatting later on, you can update all of the themed fonts at the same time. So for instance, if we change the text on this topic to be the first level font and then change the font set, you can see that the font is updated. Note that themed fonts just define the font face and not the bold or italic characteristics or its size. So if you adjust them, they will still be seen as font set fonts and updated when the font set is updated. The default text size comes from the theme. This color wheel allows you to select the text color. You can also set the text color to be automatic. When the color is automatic, you see a little white A on a black background in the color wheel. When using automatic coloring, the text color is set automatically to either the lightest or darkest color in the current color set, usually white or black. Depending on the perceptual color difference between the background that the text is drawn on and the available colors. So let's select a number of topics and change their text to be automatic color. As you can see, when the text is drawn over a dark background, the text color is light, and when the background is light, the text is dark. And this is kept up to date when you change the color of the topics or the background or enclosing boundary. In just about all themes, the default text coloring will be automatic, which means that you don't need to worry about the visibility of the text on your mind map no matter what colors you set on the mind map itself. If you set a non-automatic color for the text, then that color will be used no matter what. And if you set it to be a themed color, when you change to a different color set, then the text color will be updated. So let's change the color on this topic to be a color set color, and this topic will change the text to be a color that looks the same, but is just an ordinary color. Now you can see that when we change the color set, the themed color changes, but the explicitly set color doesn't. In most cases, you should probably be sticking to the automatic coloring so that your text is always visible. But the second option would be color set colors so that all the related text gets updated when you change to a different color set, and you would only set a custom color if you have a specific need for a color that will not change no matter what. You can use the pull-down menus on the Inspector to select the underline and strike-through styles, and use the color wheels beside them to set the color of the underlines and strike-throughs. You can align the text to be left, center, right aligned, or fully justified. Note that if your text has not wrapped and you haven't resized the topic, there will be no visible difference between the alignment options since the text already takes up the full available size on the topic. So let's just resize this topic so that you can see the differences. The text alignment is a paragraph-based formatting option, so if you want it to only apply to some of your text, then you'll need to put a paragraph break in the text using Shift Return and select the paragraph that you want to alter when applying the formatting. The text can be aligned vertically to the top, middle, or bottom of the topic. This alignment affects the entire text on the topic and positions it within the space available for the text. Therefore, if you have not increased the height of the topic beyond the height of the text, there will be no visible difference, no matter which option you select. You can get a background color drawn behind the text. This is particularly useful if you want to highlight a portion of the text. When you turn this option on, the selected text will draw a background. The color of the background is set using the associated color wheel. Note that when you have some text selected and turn this option on, you will not immediately see any changes because the selection highlight is drawn over the background. But when you change the selection, you'll see the changes that you've made. By default, Novamind uses the standard character spacing, which is optimized for readability, so you should only rarely be looking to alter the character spacing, but if you do need to have some other spacing for some reason, you can turn on the kerning option and use the slider or text area to adjust the amount of adjustment of the spacing. When you reset the text to the default, it will remove all of your custom formatting for the selected text and use the standard settings defined by the current theme and font set. While you're editing the text, you may want to have spell checking and grammar checking and similar services enabled. You can set the options that you want for spell checking and substitutions in the Preferences screen. If your version of Mac OS X doesn't handle a particular option, then it'll be disabled. If you want to go into editing notes when using the keyboard, you can use Command Quote, edit your notes, and then Shift Command Quote to go back to editing the topic. This means that you can do the content creation for your mind map without having to remove your hands from the keyboard. I hope this helps you to get the most out of the text editing in Novamind 5.